Hello everyone, myself Dr.Sunildatta N. Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to deliver a video session on load curve and load distribution curve. At the end of this session, the students will be able to explain the difference between load curve and load distribution curve. Also, we are going to discuss the effect of variable load on power plant design and operation. The contents of this video session are definition of load curve, what information we get from the load curve, what is the utility of load curve, definition of load distribution curve, how to plot load distribution curve, and what information we get from load distribution curve. Also, we are going to discuss what is the effect of variable load on power plant design and operation. Now let us see what do we mean by load curve. Now load curve, or it is also called as chronological curve, is the graphical representation of load in kilowatt or megawatt in proper time sequence, and the time is taken in hours. Here in the load curve, we plot the loads in the manner as they are appearing throughout the day or week or month or year. So that is why it is called as chronological curve. It shows the variation of load on the power station. When we plot the load curve for 24 hours in a day, then it is called as daily load curve. Also, if 1 year is considered, then it is called as annual load curve. Now let us think for a while, let us pause the video, whether the load curve for any day will be the same. Answer is no. The load curve of the power system is not same for all the days. It differs from day to day as well as season to season, as the requirement of electric power will vary throughout the day as well as from season to season. The load curve is mainly classified into two types, that is the summer load curve and the winter load curve. Now what information we get from the load curve? We are obtaining following information from the load curve. Load curve determines the variation of load during the different hours of the day. Then it also indicates the peak load on the power station, which determines the maximum demand on the power station. The area under the load curve gives the total energy generated in the period under consideration. Also, the area under the load curve divided by total number of hours, we will get the load supplied by the power station. Now let us see, the ideal load curve is flat, but practically it is never flat. It will be fluctuating all the time, and for the flat load curve, the load factor will be higher. So it will be beneficial if the load on the power station remains constant, and then we will be getting the load factor maximum. However, practically it doesn't happen. So higher load factor means more uniform load pattern with fewer variations in the load. Now what is the utility of load curve? Why do we plot the load curve? The load curve decides installed capacity of the power station. It is helpful in choosing the most economical sizes of various generating units. For example, the load on the power station is varying. As we have seen in the previous slide, it will be varying throughout the day or from season to season. So for that purpose, we need to decide the various capacities and sizes of generating unit. So looking at the pattern of the load curve, we can select properly the capacities of generating units. The load curve estimates the generating cost. We can obtain the total unit generated so that we can multiply by the cost per unit and we can get the generating cost of the power. It decides the operating schedule of the power station, that is the sequence in which the different generating units should run. Here we can say that if the load is fluctuating, then for a particular period we can operate the required set of generating unit. If the load increases, then we can add another unit into the operation so that we can produce the power as per the requirement. Now let us see, what do we mean by load duration curve? Load duration curve is defined as the curve between the load and the time in which ordinates representing the load are plotted in the order of decreasing magnitude. Here we take the time and we plot the loads in the order of decreasing magnitude, that is with the greatest load at the left and lesser loads toward the right and lowest loads at the right extreme, at the right, at the time of extreme right. Thus, the load curve represents the same data as that of the load curve, but the only difference is that here we don't take the time in chronological sequence. The load duration curve is constructed by selecting the maximum peak points and connecting them by the curve. The load duration curve plotting for 24 hours of a day is called as the daily load duration curve. Similarly, if the load duration curve is plotted for a year, it is called as the annual load duration curve. Now, let us see how we plot the load duration curve. From the data available from the load curve, we can determine the maximum load and duration for which it is occurring. Now, take the next load and the total time during which this load and the previous load occurs. Plot the loads against the time during which they are occurring in the magnitude of decreasing order. Then the load duration curve can be drawn for any duration of time, for example, for a day or a month or a year. The whole duration is taken as 100%. Now, what information we get from the load duration curve? The load duration curve gives the minimum load present throughout the specified period. It helps for selection of base load and peak load power plant. Here I mean to say that whenever the load is constant, almost uniform, then we can run the base load plant. But if the load exceeds the average load or minimum required load, then we have to operate a peak load plant for a particular period. So it will decide the selection of whether we should go for base load plant or peak load plant. Any point on the load duration curve represents total duration in hours for the corresponding load and all the loads of greater value. The area under the load duration curve represents energy associated with the load duration curve. The average demand during some specified time period, such as a day or month, can be obtained from the load duration curve. Now let us see the example, how do we plot the load curve and load duration curve. In this figure, I have taken one typical load curve. For example, here the load is in megawatt and time is in hour. So from 0 hour, that is midnight, to 4 hours, 4 a.m., the load is 5 megawatt. Then for further 4 hours, from 4 a.m. to 8 a.m., the load has increased to 15 megawatt. And then after 8 a.m. up to 16 hours, the load is 20 megawatt. Then it is decreasing back at 16 hours. And from 16 to midnight, 24 hours, the load is again uniform, that is 5 hours. So here we have plotted these loads in the order of time duration, that is chronologically the time is being plotted. Now same load curve we can utilize for plotting the load duration curve. Now let us see how the load duration curve can be plotted. So as we have seen earlier, the maximum load was 20 megawatt, which was occurring for about 8 hours. So we are plotting the peak load of, that is maximum load, 20 megawatt first. Then the next load was 15 megawatt, which was occurring for about 4 hours. So for 15 megawatt we have plotted for 4 hours, and then 5 megawatt for remaining hours. This is how we have arranged the loads in the order of decreasing magnitude with respect to the time. So this is the load distribution curve and how we can plot the load distribution curve. Now let us see what is the effect of variable load on power plant design. As we know that the load on the power plant varies time to time. Therefore, power generation in the plant must be regulated according to the demand, and the governing becomes necessary to achieve the same. Another requirement of power plant is that quick response to the load variation. So when the load requirement suddenly increases, the power plant must be able to take up the load as quick as possible. Here we can see that the thermal power plant, in case of thermal power plant, when the load increases suddenly, Then burning the extra fuel and producing the steam and supplying it to the turbine, it takes last time. So response of thermal power plant for peak load supply is going to be a little, it will be time, it will be delaying the time. Therefore, normally the thermal power plant is taken as a base load plant, and design and operation of thermal power plant for meeting variable load is more difficult. Therefore, pump storage hydroelectric plant, diesel or gas turbine units are used as peak plants due to their ability of quick response for the variable load. These are the references. Thank you.